Yes, in extension to the yesterday's class, uses of aluminium hydroxide. Aluminium hydroxide is used in getting relief of heartburn and relief from the sore nature in the stomach and also in the curage of the peptic ulcers and to promote the healing of peptic ulcers, etc. Whereas, as far the hydroxides are concerned related to the boron family, every element is forming hydroxides. The general formula is 3 OHs are present. That is boron hydroxide, aluminium, gallium, indium and the thallium. Boron hydroxide is having acidic in nature, but from top to bottom the acidic nature is goes on decreasing. So therefore, after boron hydroxide, aluminium hydroxide as well as gallium hydroxides are having amphoteric in nature, whereas indium is basic in nature and thallium hydroxide is acting as somewhat strong base. Whereas barium hydroxide is, that is boron hydroxide, is soluble in water, and as a result of reaction of water it forms, it accepts the OH minus and it is converted to BOH4 minus anion followed by the H plus, whereas remaining hydroxides are insoluble in water and they forms a gelatinous white colored precipitate. There is a special case related to the last element, that is thallium. Due to inert pair effect, thallium hydroxide is present and thallium trihydroxide is present, thallium monohydroxide is present, that is thallium with plus 3 state as well as thallium with the plus 1 state. Thallium OH3 is insoluble, but thallium OH is soluble and acting as strong base behaves similar to that of alkali metal like sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, rubidium hydroxide. In the same fashion, the properties of this thallium hydroxide are similar to that of the alkali metal hydroxides. Halides, chemical combination of element with halogens are said to be the halides. There are two varieties of halides, that is the element followed by three halogen atoms combination are known as trihalides, element followed by single halogen atom combination known as monohalides. Whereas out of these trihalides and monohalides, important halides are of boron family as well as the aluminium family are very important. After discussing boron halides as well as aluminium halides exclusively, we will give generalization related to the other varieties of halides and the general trends related to the order of the properties, either acidic properties, covalent properties, Lewis acid properties. These are all things as a generalization. At the last, after discussing of these two important halides, we will give. Yes, boron halides. All boron halides are trihalides. We never find any kind of monohalide. The general formula used for the representation of boron halides is BX3, that is boron trifluoride, boron trichloride, boron tribromide as well as boron triiodide. And the important one, boron trifluoride, majorly important one, the preparation methods of boron trifluoride. Boron trifluoride can be prepared from the boron oxide followed by hydrogen fluoride. Here fluorine is more electronegative, and in these two boron is less electro, that is more electro positive. Both combination occurs and that leads to the formation of boron trifluoride followed by what? Water molecule. There is no change in oxidation number since it is example for the non-redox reaction. Similarly, borax followed by HF with the help of sulfuric acid. Here sodium as well as the sulfates combination occurs, that is sodium bisulfate formation occurs, and the more electronegative fluorine combines with the boron leads to the formation of boron trifluoride followed by water molecules. Similarly, boron trioxide and reaction with calcium fluoride followed by sulfuric acid also leads to the formation of calcium sulfate. Remaining is what? HF. HF reaction is similar and that leads to the formation of boron trifluoride followed by water. In order to get the pure boron trifluoride, we will take the help of benzene diazonium borofluoride. This on heating undergoes rearrangement in such a way that this leads to the formation of fluorobenzene nitrogen followed by boron trifluoride formation takes place. Every of these reactions are displacement reactions, that is double displacement reactions or something else, but there is no change in oxidation numbers of any of the components, hence these are all are examples for the non-redox reactions. The other halides of the boron,
that is boron trichloride.
Boron trichloride can be prepared by B2O3 and reaction with chlorine in presence of charcoal leads to the formation of boron trichloride followed by carbon monoxide. Here carbon monoxide is a gas. Its formation includes the reaction to occur in the forward direction by making its delta G as negative. In the same way, boron reaction and reaction with bromine followed by carbon leads to boron tribromide followed by carbon monoxide. Similarly, boron triiodide, that is BI3, can be prepared by sodium borohydride followed by iodine. It leads to sodium iodide followed by BI3. Similarly, BCl3 and reaction with HI also forms the corresponding BI3 followed by HCl. But normally this reaction is not possible. To make this reaction occur, it requires very highest temperature. Yes, general properties related to the boron halides. Boron halides, with increasing of the molecular weight, with increasing of the halogen atoms weight, that is from fluorine to chlorine, chlorine to bromine, bromine to iodine, their corresponding properties varies. Thus, the intermolecular force of attractions increases with respect to the size. So therefore, this affects the physical state. Boron trifluoride and boron trichloride are gases, whereas boron tribromide is a liquid and boron triiodide under room temperature conditions is a solid. And here melting and boiling points also depends on intermolecular force of attraction. With increasing of the atomic weight, the size increases. As size increases, intermolecular force of attractions increases. As a result, the melting point and boiling points of the halides increases from boron trifluoride to boron triiodide. Similarly, let us go for the structure related to the boron halides. Boron halides, boron central atom is having group number 3 and 3 monovalent atoms are there. That is calculation of N, 3 plus 3 by 2, that will be 3 implies what? sp2 hybridization. And 3 connectivities are there, which are forming 3 sigma bonds, hence it is AB3 type, that is planar structure, bond angle is found to be 120 degrees. Whereas in case of boron trifluoride, what happens is the sizes of boron as well as the fluorine are of similar, because boron is hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, that is 2s2 2p1. Similarly, fluorine is 2p5. These two are belonging to the second period, having similarity in sizes. Such kind of atoms are having, one atom is having electron deficiency, another atom is having lone pair of electrons. Thus, in between them, a new connectivity from fluorine to boron, back bonding is possible. Due to this back bond formation here, the total bond order and the number of bonds present between the boron and the fluorine will be varied. Here, one of the lone pair present on the fluorine atom is donated towards the boron. So therefore, that may be this fluorine, this fluorine, this fluorine, and it is going to be shifted from one place to other place. Thus, it participates in resonance. All contributes, three fluorines contributes a strength of one lone pair donation by establishing another one new connectivity, which is very difficult to say. So therefore, we are expecting that one third bond is offered from this fluorine and the boron connectivity. Similarly, here one third, here also one third. Thus, the overall bonds present between boron and fluorine are 4. Whereas average bond order between boron and the fluorine are 1.33, that is 33% of bond, one third of the bond is expected. So therefore, back bond is present from fluorine to boron. So overall 4 bonds are present. Hence the bond order present between the boron and fluorine is 4/3 is equal to 1.33. This is present in case of boron trifluoride. The ability of formation of back bond is also decreases from top to bottom, that is boron trifluoride is able, whereas boron trichloride, boron tribromide and boron triiodide, if you move from top to bottom of the halides, the ability of formation of the back bond decreases because of dissimilar sizes, mismatching of the sizes, non-matching of the orbitals of donors and orbitals of the acceptors. The ability of formation of the back bonding slowly decreases from boron trifluoride to boron triiodide. Yes, boron trihalides are electron deficient. As being these are electron deficient, they are acting as Lewis acids. Boron trihalide followed by ammonia, suppose if you take, it is having lone pair of electrons. It is acting as electron pair donor, that is Lewis base. It is electron pair acceptor because it is having vacant orbital. Thus, in between them, the coordinate covalent bond connectivity will occur. Thus, not only with the ammonia, similarly with the diethyl ether, trimethyl ammonia, and the halide ion minus, with these of all, boron halides can chemically combine and forms adduct. All boron halides except boron trifluoride undergoes hydrolysis on reaction with water. Every of the boron halide except boron trifluoride gives the boric acid followed by hydrogen halides. What happens in case of boron trifluoride is BF bond is strong bond. That BF strengthened bond is not broken by the B and OH connectivity. Hence, in this case, hydrolysis does not occur. But whereas boron trichloride participates in hydrolysis, boron tribromide participates and boron triiodide also participates in the hydrolysis. And here, in case of boron trichloride, addition compound formation occurs. This is not the hydrolysis, adduct formation occurs. Whereas OH minus is taken by BF3 and the formed counter, formed negative anion containing species is counterbalanced by the positive ion H plus, that is H3O plus BF3OH minus ion formation occurs. Whereas these boron halides which are electron deficient on reaction with the corresponding hydrogen halides leads to the formation of H plus of BX4 of minus. Suppose BF3 on reaction with HF, boron trifluoride dissolves in the hydrogen fluoride. As a result, it forms H plus of BF4 minus. Such kind of compounds formation occurs. Lewis acidic strength. This is the ability of accepting of lone pair of electrons is said to be the Lewis acidic strength. Otherwise, any of the anionic species acceptancy is said to be the Lewis acidic strength. Due to back bonding, electron deficiency decreases. Because backbonding is once again what formed by the donation of lone pair of electrons. If lone pair of electrons are donated in the formation of a new bond from the more electronegative to the lower electronegative, electron deficiency decreases. So therefore, backbond is highest in boron trifluoride because of similarity size in the orbitals of the boron as well as the fluorine, and the size difference increases, hence the backbond donation ability decreases. The maximum backbond implies what? The deficiency is reduced to maximum. Hence, electron deficiency is minimum and here electron deficiency is maximum. So therefore, the place where the maximum deficiency is there, there it is acting as good Lewis acid. So therefore, from boron trifluoride to chloride, chloride to bromide and bromide to iodide, the deficiency is increasing. So therefore, the corresponding Lewis acidic nature also increasing. So therefore, Lewis acidic character compared to boron trifluoride, trichloride is having highest, boron trichloride to boron tribromide is highest, and from boron tribromide to boron triiodide is highest. Though fluorine is more electronegative than the chlorine, bromine and the iodine, we will expect generally that boron trifluoride is more electron deficient, but it is not the same. Here it is reverse. The reason for the reverse Lewis acidic character of the boron halides is, in case of boron halides, the matching of the atoms sizes leads to the backbonding. If backbond occurs, then electron deficiency decreases. If electron deficiency decreases, it is no more acting as Lewis acid. Due to this reason, here what happens is, boron trifluoride is not acting as a strong Lewis acid. Compared to boron trifluoride, trichloride is acting as Lewis acid. Compared to trichloride, tribromide is more Lewis acidic in nature, electron deficient in nature, and compared to these three, boron triiodide is more electron deficient, more Lewis acidic in character, and more ready to accept the lone pair of electrons given by any of the foreign species, other species, or the anionic species. Thus, Lewis acidic character is BF3 is greater, BF3 is lesser than BCl3, is lesser than BBr3, is lesser than Bi3. Bi3 is most Lewis acidic and BF3 is least, minimum Lewis acidic in character. Yes, uses of boron trifluoride. Boron trifluoride is used as catalyst. That boron trifluoride gas dissolved in the ether, BF3 etherate, we can say that BF3 etherate is used as Lewis acid as a catalyst. whereas BCl3 is used for the production of elemental boron by participation in reduction process. Similarly here, along with the boron trihalides, some other varieties of the halides are also present. Those are generally known as dihalides, or sometimes we can say it as tetrahalides, that is B2X4. Boron trihalides on reaction with the mercury, that is boron trichloride on reaction with mercury, it leads to the formation of HgCl2 followed by B2X4. Whereas in solid state, B2X4 structure is all, every boron as well as the chlorine atoms, everything is present on the plane. Whereas in vapor state, borons and the two chlorines are in plane and remaining two chlorine atoms are present perpendicular to the plane. Thus here, in planar, in solid state, that is planar, whereas in case of the vapor situation, they are acting in the eclipsed shape. They are present in the eclipsed shape. Such kind of presentations are present for the boron. That is, eclipsed shape is in such a way that one is projecting towards us, one is away from us, remaining all entities are expected to be present on the plane of the paper. Yes, next is aluminium halides, ALX3. Whereas aluminium important halide is aluminium chloride, that is AlCl3. It is present in two varieties of forms. One is anhydrous form and second one is normal form, that is hydrated form. Anhydrous is without having any kind of water, AlCl3 is the formula, and the hydrated form is AlCl3 6H2O, as per the empirical relation is concerned. Whereas this particular anhydrous can be prepared on heating red hot aluminium turnings with either dry HCl gas, or on reaction with the chlorine leads to the formation of anhydrous aluminium chloride, that is also present in the gaseous form. On cooling, condenses to the solid in physical state because it is not having any kind of liquid physical state. Thus on condensation, anhydrous AlCl3 is gaseous anhydrous, gaseous AlCl3 is converted to anhydrous AlCl3. It can also be prepared from heating of alumina Al2O3 followed by carbon and the dry chlorine gases. It leads to the formation of carbon monoxide followed by AlCl3. This gas on condensation leads to the formation of AlCl3 solid. Carbon monoxide remains as a gas, we can remove later. Thus, anhydrous aluminium chloride can be prepared. Whereas hydrated, the same reactions, aluminium on reaction with dilute HCl solution gives to the formation of aluminium chloride followed by hydrogen gas, and it is present in the form of hexahydrate. Similarly, aluminium hydroxide on reaction with dilute HCl solution leads to the formation of aluminium chloride hexahydrate followed by water molecules. The crystals of hydrated aluminium chloride can be separable. Like this, we can prepare anhydrous aluminium chloride as well as the hydrated aluminium chloride. Yes, properties of aluminium chloride. Now we will discuss these properties in two ways. One is anhydrous aluminium chloride and second one is hydrated aluminium chloride. Related to anhydrous aluminium chloride, it is a white colored solid and it is daily present in nature. It is very ready to accept the water molecules from the atmosphere, and it fumes in air. On heating, it sublimes at 180 degree centigrade, and from the vapor density related molecular weight, relevant empirical formula and the molecular formula reveals that it is not present as a monomer, it is present in the form of dimer, that is Al2Cl6. It is covalent in nature, that is anhydrous aluminium chloride is covalent in nature. It doesn't conduct any kind of current, electricity. It is soluble in organic solvent. Because it is covalent in nature, like alcohols, ethers, benzene like solvents, it is very much soluble. And let us go for the hydrated aluminium chloride, that is AlCl3 6H2O. Whereas this is obtained by heating of dry AlCl3 with water. Dry AlCl3 and exposure towards the water, it leads to the formation of AlCl3 6H2O. Whereas due to its high heat of hydration, here it takes up the water molecule and it is existing in the form of hexahydrate. That's what it is. Dry is converted into hexahydrate, that is hydrated aluminium chloride. And it is present in the form of AlH2O6 followed by Cl3-Cl3. In such a form it is present. Whereas in aqueous solution, it will be present in the form of AlCl2H2O4 positive cation followed by AlCl4H2O2 negative anion, And at the same time, on heating, what happens is due to its water of hydration, due to its water of crystallization, these water molecules makes the electron deficient AlCl3 to participate in hydrolysis. As a result, the hydrated aluminium chloride is converted on heating to aluminium hydroxide, AlOH3. Aluminium hydroxide formation occurs. This is due to hydrolysis of its water of hydration. Because AlCl3 is electron deficient, it is having vacant orbitals. In that vacant orbitals, the lone pair of electron present on the oxygen of water molecule is donated. As a result, replacement of all chlorines is possible. Thus, it leads to the formation of aluminium hydroxide. Yes, properties of anhydrous aluminium chloride. Aluminium chloride is existing in the form of dimer Al2Cl6. Here the vacant orbital, through the vacant orbital of the aluminium, chlorine donates the lone pair. Similarly, from here, lone pair of chlorine is once again donated towards the vacant orbital of aluminium. Thus, two units are connected, having the formula as Al2Cl6. It fumes in moisture. On reaction with moisture, nothing but water, it leads to the formation of aluminium hydroxide followed by HCl. HCl is a gas, it fumes. That's what it is having, fuming nature. And it is acidic in nature because due to hydrolysis, a strong acid HCl is produced. On dissolution in water, already we made the discussion, anhydrous aluminium chloride on dissolution in water, it is converted to hydrated aluminium chloride, that is AlCl6H2O. It is having ionic nature, that is, here it is present in the form of aluminium or aluminium complex in the form of cation followed by Cl minus as anion, whereas it is acting as electron deficient species, hence it can take up the electrons from the electron donors. Thus, in the presence of Lewis bases like ammonia, it forms an adduct. AlCl3 6 ammonia molecules can combine and present in the form of an adduct. Similarly, on reaction with ammonium hydroxide, here AlCl3 is converted to aluminium hydroxide followed by ammonium chloride. Double displacement reaction occurs. And in the presence of aluminium chloride, this aluminium hydroxide is also insoluble, hence it is present in the form of a white precipitate. On reaction with sodium hydroxide, with limited amount of sodium hydroxide, it forms first the precipitate, that is aluminium hydroxide white gelatinous precipitate formation occurs. And still addition of sodium hydroxide, if takes place, further reaction takes place, and that leads to the formation of sodium meta-aluminate, which is soluble inside the sodium hydroxide solution, that is soluble sodium meta-aluminate formation occurs. These are the properties associated with the anhydrous aluminium chloride. Yes, uses of anhydrous aluminium chloride. It is used as Lewis acid. It is used as catalyst in the organic reactions like Friedel-Crafts reaction, and also in the manufacture of gasoline from the hydrocarbons, higher hydrocarbons, by cracking process, and in the preparation of dyes, drugs, perfumes, etc., and also as a moderant in dyes. Generalization over the halides of the boron family. Yes, boron trichloride, aluminium trichloride are electron deficient as well as acting as Lewis acids, whereas boron halides are monomeric in nature. Aluminium halide important is aluminium chloride, which is present in dimeric in nature. Why this boron halide does not form any kind of dimer? Because boron size is smaller, it can't accommodate the bigger sized halide ions, can't coordinate the bigger sized halide ions. Due to this reason, it is remained as monomer, whereas aluminium can accommodate because it is also bigger in size, hence it is present in the form of dimer. In addition to the regular trihalides, they can form di as well as the monohalides also. Examples for the dihalides, B2X4 and gallium Cl4 are examples. Whereas related to this, explanation was given in vapor state, it is present in the form of, and in the solution state how it is present will be given. And at the same time, this gallium halide is present in the form of ionic, and it is present in the complex formation of Ga plus of GaX4. Here gallium is having plus 1 state, and here gallium is having plus 3 state, it is having ionic in nature. The elements of this group in gaseous state forms another one halide, that is monohalide, but that is very unstable and that is covalent in nature. whereas the covalent nature related to the different varieties of the trihalides, suppose boron halide, aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium halides, if you observe for a particular halogen atom of the different elements of the group from top to bottom, the covalent nature decreases. So top elements related halides are covalent in nature, whereas the bottom elements related halides are ionic in nature. Thallium halides are ionic in nature. In that way, the covalent nature is expected to be decreasing from top to bottom. Alloys. Whereas metal combination with other metals and metal combination with the non-metals leads to the special properties containing homogeneous solid mixtures are known as alloys. Aluminium is important metal to form different varieties of alloys, because the aluminium alloys are having nature like, they are having light in weight and the high mechanical strength containing properties are associated, having high tensile strength, very strong and also takes polish. Due to these reasons, aluminium alloys are favorable. The important aluminium alloys are magnesium, duralumin, YLI and the aluminium branch. The corresponding composition in magnesium is, aluminium is 95% and magnesium consisting of magnesium, and that is of 5%. It is used in making of balances and pistons of the engines, as well as the airships making also we will use this alloy. Duralumin is consisting of aluminium as major, followed by copper, manganese as well as the magnesium, with 95, 4, 0.5 and 0.5%. These are used in making of automobiles as well as the aeroplane spare parts. YLI, very important alloy. Aluminium, copper, nickel, magnesium combination is there. It is consisting 95% of aluminium, copper with 4%, followed by nickel 2%, magnesium 1%. And it is used in making of machinery parts, followed by the pistons of the engines. Whereas aluminium branch, here aluminium is not major. Copper is major, copper is 88%, aluminium is 11.5%, tin is 0.5%. It is used for making of the photo frames, coins, cheaper jewelry, as well as the utensils of the household. Such kind of materials are made with the help of the alloys made up of aluminium.